Hey, how's it going, guys? This is Eckyman, and today we're going to be checking out Salt. So this is a first-person exploration slash survival game, and I think we should just jump straight into the game and explain a few things as we go. So of course we're going to call ourselves Eckyman, we'll leave the world seed alone, and the game mode, and we will get going. Okay, so we have a few objectives to meet once we get into the game. Basically, this game's all about surviving and exploring. So with that said, we need to, here we go, obtain a few items to help us on the way with that. So if we hit H here, welcome to the world of Salt. This world is about exploration, adventure, and discovery. This book will help you get your adventure started. Okay, so we have a bunch of basic controls here. Inventory's tab, E, right click, utilities U, right, okay. Dodge is space and ASD, primary attack, block, access your inventory by pressing tab, crafting by pressing C. Boats, yeah, we need to make a boat, that's one of the things I want to get accomplished today. Resting, we can do that at campfire. Bottom left of your screen are two bars, larger one is your food meter. The lower it is, the more hungry you are, and you recover stamina at a much slower rate. Okay, so I guess this is our stamina for running and stuff like that. Yep, sprinting, swimming, and dodging. Combat, primary attack, secondary attack, and dodging. Secondary attacks and dodging generally use stamina. And we need a weapon, hotkeys, all that good stuff. Okay, well, let's jump straight into this then. So I already know a little bit about this game. And the first thing we need to look for, well, we need wood. So we need to keep an eye out for wood, like we have right here. Now, somewhere on this island, there will also be a pickaxe. And I would love to try and find that. We can make one ourselves, but if we can get a freebie, that would be awesome, obviously. And also, there should be a chest hidden somewhere on this first island with some very essential supplies within. So we're going to keep an eye out for that. What's this down here? Plant fibers. Okay, that's fine. So we'll keep a relatively high viewpoint while we look around. Oh, also, we need to walk through some of these bamboo areas. Because if we find a piece of exceptional bamboo, which we can do just by walking through them, we can create a fishing pole, which obviously will be useful for gaining food. Okay. Let's see in this chest. Aha! Here we go. Here's the chest. Cool. So we'll open this. We'll loot all. And let's take a look at our inventory here. So we got some plant fibers. Oh no, we already picked that up. We got some cloth swatch, some coal, and some gold coin. And we also got this strange journal as well, so can we read this? To the person unknown to me, I happened upon you laying here while I was searching this island. I gave you a few hard shakes, but you did not respond. I thought that I would leave you this message in the event that you do eventually awake. I made a stop on this island to search for some provisions. While foraging, I ran upon an unlocked chest with a few materials in it. By the looks of you, I would find it strange if the chest was yours, but I left its contents untouched for you just in case. You might consider using the cloth I saw in there, along with some wood, to craft a basic sail raft. It is unlikely that remaining on this island would be in your best interest. Cool. Okay, so we found the chest. So next up, we need to find a pickaxe. So we need to keep a sharp eye out for that. We're going to be able to use the pickaxe to harvest stone. And I assume we could use it as a weapon. We'll get to that in a second, though. We can craft a basic club, which I may do pretty soon. Yeah, so we need to have a good look around this entire island. I would rather not leave without finding the pickaxe, that's for sure. I'm just wondering how easy it's going to be to see this thing, though. Might be hidden in the undergrowth somewhere. I'm also just taking the time to run through the... Oh, there we go. Pickaxe. Awesome. Cool. So, what we want to do now is equip this pickaxe. And we need to find some stone, which looks like this, but it's more of a sort of a rock on the ground. Like a separate bit rather than just built into the scenery. I'm not seeing any. Still need to keep walking through this bamboo. We will get a pop-up when we find the bamboo, which is cool. And here's our weak boulder, so we need to attack this. There we go, and we got ourselves some stone blocks from that. That's cool. Also, let's just hit C. I want to put some wood logs in there and make a club. Oops. Right, so we hit craft, and that makes us a basic club, which we can then equip. So we'll do that now. The reason I want to do this is some of these trees. Don't think it's that one, though. Oh, we can see one here. There is some fruit hanging from this tree. So if we give that a whack, there we go. We've got ourselves some food. Need to keep an ear out so you can hear when fruit drops, basically. So none from that one. Fruit we can eat, but we can also use some of the fruit as a an ingredient for... Sorry, I just have to keep stopping talking so I can hear if we get a fruit drop. We can use it to make a fishing pole. So we still need logs and some more stone. So that's cool, we found some here. Loot all. So if we get enough stone, we can craft a weapon using the logs and the stone. Or a better weapon than this. We can make a sword, I believe. So I would love to find some more stone before we leave the island. There are things to fight as well. There is combat in this game. There are other pirates. And I believe animals as well that we can hunt. Okay, nothing from you. Keep walking through the bamboo. Definitely got to walk through it, right? And not hit it. Yeah, we've got to walk through it. Okay. So we've got some more of the trees that drop fruit here. I'm starting to think we've maybe been all around the island, but I'm not sure. It's not too large, this first one. Shouldn't be too difficult for us to get around it. Weird. Sounds like there's a truck right outside my house. Good timing, guy. Oh, there's our chest. So we have been all around it. There's some fruit, though, so we will give that a little whack. They do glow, so technically you can find them just by having a look around. We'll check all these trees. So off in the distance there, you can see various different islands, and we want to make our way to one of those today. But before we do that, we want to make sure that we've got everything that we can from this island, which means all the logs we can pick up, and as much stone as we can get as well. I'd love to make a weapon, or a better weapon than this club, before we leave. Not sure we're necessarily going to be able to do that, but... yeah, we need to keep a sharp eye out for that. Keep saying that. Keep a sharp eye out. Keep a sharp eye out for this. Keep a sharp eye out for that. I'm starting to think, though, that we may have got everything we need from this island, and maybe we will go and visit somewhere else. These are the right trees, aren't they? Oh, that sounded like something dropped. No, maybe not. Definitely not. Okay, well, first things first, we can put some wood log in here and some cloth swatch. That enables us to make a sail raft, so that's 7 wood and 2 fabric. We can also make a flag out of 1 wood and 1 cloth, and that enables us to mark islands that we have already visited, so that's pretty handy. Now, how do you make cloth, you might ask? Well, we loot all that stuff, and if we were to put plant fibers, into our inventory, there you go. 3 plant fibers creates 1 cloth. So, that's how we do that, but we're not going to create a flag just yet. Instead, we're going to have a bit more of a look around. And there's some wood. Come on, I'd love to just find a couple more boulders. Because something tells me that this club's not going to be too good in combat. Still don't think we've found an exceptional piece of bamboo yet either. No. We have coal as well, so we can combine that with logs to make torches, of course. So I'm assuming we have a day-night cycle in this game as well. I don't think it's like a strict survival game in that if we start... We're not going to starve if we run out of food, but we won't be able to regain our stamina half as quick as before. So that's going to affect fighting and running and all that good stuff. And there we go, exceptional piece of bamboo. Now, ripe tree fruit. I think we can craft if we put that in... Oh, no. Huh, good job he didn't eat it. So if we put that in with that and that... No, okay. We'll figure that out later. I don't have a handle on all the crafting stuff, so there's going to be a lot of trial and error while we sort through stuff to find... I believe you can find journals in the game that will tell you how to craft things. Alright, so I'm sort of feeling like we've explored the middle section of the island enough. So we're going to go around the edge here and see if we can find any rocks that we can use. And hopefully this video will be going up at 60 frames per second again. Quite pleased with how the Binding of Isaac video turned out. I think the gameplay looks so much smoother on YouTube in 60 frames per second. So that's really awesome. The only downside to it is, man alive, does it take a long time to render those files. So that Isaac video, just to put this in perspective, that was a 40-minute video file, or a 39-minute video file, and it took over an hour, quite a bit over an hour actually, I think it was coming up on an hour and a half, to render it. Now of course I was watching some Netflix with my wife at the time, so that could have been slowing it down. There's a chance it could have been done a bit quicker. Also, my current render program does not support my graphics card for rendering, which, as most of you know, was one of the reasons I wanted to get the fancy new graphics card, was so that I could render using it. So what I'm doing is I will be upgrading my render program today from Sony Vegas HD Movie Studio Platinum 11, that's a mouthful to say, to the 13 version, which does support my graphics card. And I did a little bit of testing with a trial version, and it does seem like it's going to shave 15 or 20 minutes per render time off my renders. When I'm doing it 60 frames per second anyway, so I think it's a worthwhile thing to have. I am not seeing any rocks on this island anymore, so I guess we are going to leave. Now over there, it looks like we've got a ship in the distance. I don't want to go to that island straight away. I want to try and find some more stone, so I can make a weapon, or a better weapon than this. We can also make armor as well. I wonder if this island would be worth checking out. It looks kind of closer than that one. Not really sure on how to make the campfires either, so I need to look up a few crafting information guides if possible. Of course, if you guys know any of the crafting stuff, please feel free to post it in the comments. I don't really mind so much getting a few spoilers with this. Okay, so look towards close water and double-click your boat to place it. So double-click, and boom, we have a boat. Awesome. So let's jump in the water here. Press E to get on it. Press E to unfurl our sail, and we are off. This is really cool. So we can steer ourselves like this. Unfortunately, we can't look where we're going while we are steering, which is a bit of a shame. Although it does seem like... we can potentially... No, we can't see where we're going. Okay. So we need to turn our raft. And we're heading towards this place here. My dog's up and about. Hopefully he doesn't cause us any hassle. Looks like we could potentially get a lot of rock from this place. So that's cool. That's exactly the sort of thing I'm looking for. And as we get closer to the island, we're going to click E and put our sail away and just coast up to the beach. So we'll press E on here. That enables us to move around a bit, jump off our boat, and I really hope it's going to stay right there. Okay, so a new island, and we're going to equip our club just in case we get any hostile attempts on our life. And we're going to scan around, see if we can find anything cool. So really we're looking for stone on this island right here. Wow, I'm getting some frames per second drops. That's kind of crazy. Is this a boulder we can hit? Nope, because I'm not getting a health icon on it. Okay, that's fine. Aha, but this is. Why am I getting frames per second drops? This is crazy. Loot all. Cool. And here we go, here's another one. And it looks like some wood down there as well. So we're going to grab that as well. Loot all. Yeah, my dog's definitely up and about. Something's caught his interest. And he's sitting by the door now, so I guess he wants to go out, which is not too bad. Oh, he's having a shake. We are coming up on 20 minutes anyway, so we'll just explore a little bit longer. And then I will go and see to my dog. Hang on, buddy. I'll come let you out in a second. Now, there's a campfire. Is that a person down there? It could be. Do we really want to go and check this out? It is a person. Yeah, we might just give them a wide berth for now. We can use campfires to rest and heal up. However, until we've got... Well, let's have a look here. I believe we need 7 stone blocks. I could be wrong with that. And my dog's still whining. Hang on, bud. I'll sort you out in a second. We put those into our inventory. No, we can't craft anything. Alright, we're going to give this a wide berth, but we could potentially assault it with our pickaxe. But I'm thinking we might just be wiser jumping on our boat and heading off somewhere else, seeing if we can find some stuff without having to get in a fight just yet. We might be fine with the pickaxe, we might not be. What do we have here? Grub collected, okay. Some plant fibers, a white flower. So I know we can make potions from flowers. I believe we need 2 flowers of the same type and then we can make something with that. That's the island we just came from. It looks like I can see a mast on the horizon there. We can make a better boat than this as well. So we might look into doing that. Yeah. I'm just very reluctant to go near that campfire just yet. We'll probably try and assault it in the next episode. We are getting close to the end of the episode today. So I guess we'll save combat for the next episode. And what have we got? What have we got? Anything else we can take from our surroundings? Let me see. What was that? Nothing at all. Nothing at all. A bit of a Flanders for you there. Okay, well, yeah, I think what we'll do is we'll jump back on our raft, we'll head somewhere else, and we'll see if we can gather some more supplies, or we'll do a bit of combat. I'm not really sure yet. I'll have a think about that. Like I say, I would love to try and make a sword, though, before we take on any pirates. But yeah, I definitely want to show you guys a bit of combat. The pirates are kind of funny looking. It's very much in keeping with the graphic style of the game, which I really like. I like this. It's very vibrant. It's not going for realism. There's, you know, there's bushes, but it's not like overgrowth everywhere. And my dog's decided to join me back on the couch. Look at that. So, the moon's coming up. So we're actually coming up on our first day-night cycle. We definitely sailed from over there. I'm thinking we should head over to that island over there next. But anyway, yeah, I guess I'm going to call this the end of the episode here, guys. Let me know what you think about this in the comments. Salt is available on Steam. You can check it out over there. And so far, I'm really enjoying it. It's quite nice to be playing a... I know there's combat in it, but it does feel very peaceful. I like the mechanic of being able to explore different islands. And I'm pretty stoked that we're going to be able to fight some pirates in this, basically. So, yeah, anyway, I'm going to call this the end of the episode, guys. Let me know what you think. I'm out for now, and I will see you soon for some more Salt. Peace.